Open the pod bay doors, Hal.
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that. This mission is too important for me to allow you to jeopardize it.
The story of artificial intelligence has come a long way since 1968's 2001, A Space Odyssey. In the film, HAL, also known as HAL 9000, but more informally, just HAL, is a sentient AI system that controls the spacecraft's operations. And when HAL catches wind that his crew wants to unplug him, he attempts to kill all humans on board. Fair enough, really. Today, artificial intelligence touches every aspect of our lives. We ask Alexa for the latest weather report, use precision agriculture techniques to keep farmers informed about the status of their crops. Smartphone apps using AI can even help detect early stages of skin cancer. AI's future looks bright. Self-driving cars are closer than you think, and when adopted, they will bring new mobility to housebound seniors and the disabled. AI will disrupt healthcare, where life-saving robots will bring greater medical access to underserved regions. But is it possible that the awesome power of AI could become a driver of greater inequality? Of course, many workers fear robot takeover, and for those without a college degree in the industrial and manufacturing sectors, those fears are clearly justified. One study in 2020 found that industrial robots brought down wages and led to much greater displacement amongst workers. But with these declines for workers also came greater productivity and profit for companies, as well as lower costs for consumers. So money is being made, maybe not redistributed. AI has also helped power us through the pandemic. Zoom uses artificial intelligence to help with video compression, audio processing, and all those neat virtual backdrops that I personally hate. And while faking an exotic location during a meeting that could have been an email, probably should have been, might impress your colleagues, though in reality it just annoys them, the power behind all this technology has a darker side.
We're entering an era in which our enemies can make it look like anyone is saying anything at any point in time, even if they would never say those things. Moving forward, we need to be more vigilant.
That's comedian Jordan Peele narrating a deepfake video of former President Barack Obama in a public service announcement warning viewers to be more vigilant with what we trust from the internet or from comedians. Similar facial recognition AI is also being trained by the Chinese government to surveil Uyghurs, a severely repressed Muslim minority in China, according to the New York Times and other media outlets. And HAL from 2001, A Space Odyssey? Well, I mean, killer robots are no longer a far-off vision of dystopian nightmares. We can have them right here. A United Nations report detailed the use of an autonomous military drone in Libya that was used during an altercation between the former UN-recognized Government of National Accord and forces aligned with General Khalifa Haftar. Should the use of killer robots ever be okay? Which world power will win the AI race? It's either the US or China. And as AI becomes smarter and more powerful, what does I think, therefore I am, even mean anymore?